here at the Burke's Pepper Jam in Bethel, Pennsylvania.
Smell that.
An annual festival of food, entertainment, and contests, all centered on chili peppers.
We begin our contest with the long hots. Let's turn up the heat!
And we're off.
Zesty, with just a hint of poison.
Round two, we're gonna start with the red Fresno pepper.
Gotta be some easier way to learn about molecules.
All right, are we ready?
That was not designed for human consumption.
Round number four, habanero peppers.
Parts of my body I didn't know I had are on fire.
10 more seconds, you got this.
I can't.
Don't do it! No! The orange Copenhagen pepper.
What am I doing? Oh man, oh my God.
Don't do it!
I want it! Cheers!
So, I'm the first to fall. How does a pepper's capsaicin convince my mouth it's on fire?
Not recommended.
I think I'll find the answer here at Penn State University's Department of Food Science.
We all study food, so you have psychologists and microbiologists and engineers.
I'm here to see John Hayes. He knows a thing or two about the active ingredients in these.
So when you went and tasted them, what did you experience?
Oh man, my gut twisted, my tongue burned, my flesh burned, I cried, I got red, my nose ran. It's like putting your tongue on the stove and leaving it there.
That was an aversive response. This plant has evolved a chemical called capsaicin. And the reason it makes that is to keep animals from eating the chili pepper.
Man, the chili festival people never got that message. And we're just a really stupid species.
Exactly. We're one of the only species that learns to like that sensation.
Ultimately, pepper plants are playing a pretty good trick on humans as well. Capsaicin really is a key ingredient. It has a long, spindly tail attached to a ring.
That ring end fits into a specific receptor that's expressed all over your body.
Not just our tongue.
Not just your tongue.
Oh, man.
This receptor, this lock, is actually a heat pain sensor.
Normally, the receptor, called TRPV1, activates when it comes in contact with something over 106 degrees. The result is a pain message to the brain. Ouch! Something's hot!
It's a warning signal to tell your body danger.
And here's the tricky part. When you eat peppers, those capsaicin keys fit into the heat pain receptors in your mouth, altering their sensitivity.
And so what the capsaicin does is it fits into this molecular thermometer and it lowers the temperature at which it activates it.
Like a changed thermostat, they now activate at body temperature, sending a false signal that's identical to the one your brain would receive if you ate something literally burning hot.
It lowers the temperature at which we feel burning pain.
Yes.
But it's not actually burning us?
Correct.
I'm not gonna see scar tissue.
No.
No matter how hot it is. It's all a fake out?
Absolutely.